All India Radio presents Morning News. Good morning, I'm Tanvi Taneja. The headlines. Government to move Muslim women protection of rights on marriage bill in Rajya Sabha today. Prime Minister Narendra Modi says any decision on Ram temple only after court's verdict. Says his government's priority is to empower the farmer by pulling him out of debt trap. Army Chief General Bipin Rawat reviews security situation along LOC and hinterland in Jammu and Kashmir. Reserve Bank offers relief to small and medium manufacturing entrepreneurs, allows restructuring of debt up to 25 crore rupees. No need for license under Arms Act to manufacture defence, aerospace and warship items, says government. ISRO launches Samwad with students to engage them in space science activities. And in Women's National Boxing Championships, Chandigarh, Delhi and Punjab boxers swept away majority of wins on second day. The Muslim Women Protection of Rights on Marriage Bill is scheduled to be tabled in the Rajya Sabha today. Law and Justice Minister Ravi Shankar Prasad will move the bill in the House. It was passed by the Lok Sabha last week amid a walkout by the opposition. The bill makes all declarations of instant triple talaq void and illegal. It seeks to make the practice a punishable offence with imprisonment of 3 years. Our correspondent reports that Rajya Sabha witnessed uproar over the bill on Monday as Congress-led opposition persisted with its demand that it should be referred to the Select Committee of the House for scrutiny.
The fresh triple talaq bill to make the practice a penal offence was introduced in Lok Sabha on December 17 to replace an ordinance issued in September. This bill will supersede an earlier bill passed in the Lok Sabha and pending in the Rajya Sabha. But amid opposition by some parties in the Rajya Sabha, the government had cleared some amendments, including introduction of a provision of bail to make it more acceptable. However, as the bill continued to face resistance in the Rajya Sabha, the government issued an ordinance in September incorporating the amendment. Suparna Sekia, AIR News, Delhi.
Prime Minister Narendra Modi has made it clear that a decision on bringing an ordinance on Ram Temple at Ayodhya can be taken after court's verdict. In an interview to a news agency yesterday, he accused the Congress of delaying the Ayodhya verdict in the Supreme Court. Mr. Modi said Congress lawyers are creating hurdles in the apex court so that an early judgment is not delivered.
मैं कांग्रेस के साथियों से विशेष रूप से विनती करता हूं कि वे उनके अपने वकीलों को कोर्ट के अंदर इस मसले में रुकावट डालने वाले एजेंडा से बाहर निकालें और सभी वकील मित्र जो भी कांग्रेस से जुड़े हुए हैं जो इसको रोकने के लिए कोशिश कर रहे हैं वो भी कोर्ट में जाकर के जल्दी से जल्दी न्यायिक प्रक्रिया पूरी हो उसमें हम बल लगाएं न्याय की प्रक्रिया को न्याय के तरीके से चलने दिया जाए उसको राजनीति के तराजू से न तोला जाए.
The Prime Minister said his government's priority is to empower the farmer by pulling him out of the debt trap. He said loan waiving is not the ideal solution to their debts. Mr. Modi alleged that the Congress is misleading the nation by announcing farm loan waivers in the states governed by the party.
हम देश के किसानों को समझाना ये मीडिया की भी जिम्मेवारी है. क्या कर्ज माफी करके किन किसानों को फायदा होता है? देश का बहुत कम वर्ग ऐसा है जो बैंकों से लोन लेता है. ज्यादातर किसान साहूकार के पास से लोन लेता है और ये जब सरकार योजना बनाती है तो उसमें वो किसान नहीं आता है. जो किसान को मरना पड़ रहा है वो इस व्यवस्था का हिस्सा नहीं है, वो उसे बाहर है और इसलिए ये सिर्फ चुनावी स्टंट किए जा रहे हैं.
On Rafael, the Prime Minister said he has already made a statement on the issue in Parliament and the Supreme Court has also given its verdict.
संसद में मैंने विस्तार से इसका जवाब दिया है. जहां भी मुझे पब्लिक में बोलने का मौका मिला है मैंने इस विस्तार से बताया है. सुप्रीम कोर्ट तक मसला क्लियर हो चुका है. फ्रांस के राष्ट्रपति जी ने बयान दे दिया है, भारत के प्रधानमंत्री ने बयान दे दिया है. इतना कर लीजिए, जो इतने सवाल मुझे पूछ रहे हैं कोई मीडिया में हिम्मत होनी चाहिए उनको पूछे कि ठहरिए भाई आप बताइए, सिद्ध कीजिए, आप जो आरोप लगा रहे हैं हमें बताइए, ऐसे पत्थर मार के भाग मत जाइए.
Rashtriya Swayam Sevak Sangh RSS has welcomed Prime Minister Narendra Modi's remarks on construction of Ram Temple in Ayodhya. In a statement, RSS Joint General Secretary Dattatreya Hosbole said the remarks by the Prime Minister is a positive step in the direction of temple construction. The RSS leader said the Prime Minister reiterating the resolve to construct a grand Ram temple in Ayodhya is in tune with the resolution passed by the BJP at Palampur in 1989. Karnataka BJP President B.S. Yediyurappa has taken strong exception to the remarks made by JDS President H.D. Devegowda on the Prime Minister's statement about the farmers' loan waiver issue. Mr. Yediyurappa in a statement said, the Prime Minister's statement on waiver of loans of only 800 farmers is based on the documents released by the state. He said, the state government had promised to waive off crop loans of 24 lakh farmers in 24 hours, but even after 7 months of forming the government, the promise remains on paper. Mr. Devegowda yesterday claimed that 60,000 farmers benefited with the state government scheme and not just 800. Army Chief General Bipin Rawat reviewed the security situation along the line of control and the hinterland in Jammu and Kashmir. General Rawat, accompanied by Northern Army Commander Lieutenant General Ranbir Singh and Chinar Corps Commander Lieutenant General A.K. Bhatt, visited the frontier district of Kupwara yesterday. The Army Chief was briefed about the recent counter-infiltration operations. He interacted with the troops and spent the New Year Day with troops in the Kashmir Valley. Army spokesperson said General Rawat was appreciative of the sharp vigil and alertness along the line of control and the high morale of the troops and further exhorted them to remain alert for any eventuality. The Army chief, who arrived in a two-day visit of the state yesterday, also interacted with senior police officials and discussed the prevailing internal security situation in the valley. This is All India Radio giving you the news. For quick news updates, run the clock. Follow us on our Twitter handle at AIR News Alerts. You can also log on to our website news.air.nic.in. Reserve Bank has allowed a one-time restructuring of existing debt of up to 25 crore rupees for the companies which have defaulted on payment, but the loans given to them have continued to be classified as standard assets. The decision will help the micro, small and medium enterprises, MSMEs, which are facing cash crunch in the wake of demonetization and GST implementation. The Central Bank in a statement said that to facilitate meaningful restructuring of MSME accounts that have become stressed, the RBI has decided to permit a one-time restructuring of existing loans to MSMEs that are in default but standard as on 1st of January this year. Manufacturing of defence, aerospace and warship items will now be covered by Industries Development and Regulation Act, IRDA, and it will not require any licence from the Commerce and Industry Ministry. A government notification issued yesterday said that the Department of Industrial Policy and Promotion under the Ministry has issued a notification clarifying the defence products list requiring compulsory licence under IRDA 1951 and the Arms Act 1959 in consultation with Ministry of Home Affairs and Department of Defence Production. The department in a tweet said items of defence aerospace and warships now do not require license under the Arms Act and such items shall now be covered by IDRA. Indian Space Research Organization ISRO has launched Samwad with students as part of its outreach program. The Indian Space Agency will engage youngsters across the country in activities concerning space science under this program. During the inauguration in Bengaluru yesterday, 40 students and 10 teachers from select schools interacted with ISRO chairman Dr. K. Shivan about the Indian space program and their benefits to the common man. During the three-hour stay at ISRO head office, the students and teachers also interacted with scientists and engineers. Here is a report from our correspondent.
The outreach program of ISRO aims at infusing scientific temper among the Indian youth. It has planned various interaction programs with the students to motivate them towards science and space research. It will also organize guided tours of students twice a year to ISRO facilities in Thiruvananthapuram, Bengaluru and Sriharikota. A selected few will also be allowed to make small satellites. Sudhindra, AIR News, Bengaluru.
The Meteorological Department has issued a weather warning for Jammu and Kashmir, where surface transport could get affected and there is also a threat of avalanche during the next 48 hours. In addition, higher reaches of Kashmir Valley, Ladakh and hilly areas of Jammu may get heavy snowfall in isolated places. The Met Department last evening said a stronger western disturbance originating in Arabian Sea was approaching, which could hit western Himalayan region during the next 48 hours. Under its influence, widespread rain or snow is likely to occur in Himachal Pradesh today. In international news, in Mali, 37 civilians were killed and many were injured when armed men, believed to be traditional Dogon hunters, attacked the village of Fulani herders yesterday. The violence was fueled by a dispute over access to land and water. The government said that the attackers, who were dressed as traditional Dogon hunters, raided the Kologan village in the Mopti region of the country. On to sports. Chandigarh, Delhi and Punjab boxers swept away majority of the wins on the second day of the third Women's National Boxing Championships in Vijayanagar, Karnataka yesterday. The day began with a dominating performance by Delhi's Rhea Tokas in the 54kg category as she beat V. Vinodhini from Tamil Nadu. Sohini from Chandigarh showed her sublime form against Sai Shri Reddy from Telangana in the 69kg category. Babita Bisht of Uttarakhand beat Suman Khoda of Rajasthan in the 69kg category. In the bantamweight category, Rhea Chauhan of Punjab beat Paulomi Sarkar from Bengal. And in the welterweight category, Gagandeep Kaur of Punjab beat Simran Medho of Maharashtra. And now for an overview of today's newspapers. It's over to Abhishek Kumar.
Thank you, Tanvi. Prime Minister Narendra Modi giving his first interview of 2019 to a news agency is the lead story of almost all newspapers today. The Hindustan Times writes, Ram Mandir move only after court order, says Modi. The Asian Age quotes the PM as saying, wrong to think Pakistan might mend ways. In a swipe at Gandhi's, PM says, nation's first family is out on bail, hits Congress farm stunts. The DNA in an exclusive story highlights, BJP thinks global. Congress takes micro route for 2019. The paper says that while BJP is activating its volunteers in 25 countries for campaigning, Congress to take inputs on the selection of candidates across the country through its data analytics team's digital platform, Shakti. Election Commission asks voters to walk last mile as poll deadline nears, headlines the Hindustan Times. The paper says that voters are being encouraged to verify their details as duplicate entries and missing names became a flashpoint between the poll body and some political parties in the last round of elections. The Tribune highlights that market fees and GST worth over 200 crore rupees on cotton is being evaded in Haryana every year after non-existent firms. 50% of cotton procured without bill, headlines the Daily. 8 lakh paid tributes at Bhima Koregaon on the 201st anniversary of the battle, writes the DNA. The Hindustan Times writes, a year after violence, Bhima Koregaon turns into a sea of blue, referring to the wave of blue flags and raising slogans of Jai Bhim for Dr. B. R. Ambedkar at Memorial in Pune. Several newspapers have paid their tributes to late actor Kader Khan, who passed away in Canada yesterday. Hum jahan khade hote hain, line wahin se shuru hoti hai. Engineer, script writer, actor, dialogue writer. Kader Khan was all these and more, writes the Tribune. And finally, the Indian Express and the Times of India have front-paged photographs of the women wall formed by over 35 lakh women spread across 620 kilometers from 4 to 4:15 p.m. in Kerala. This human chain was part of a state-backed initiative to uphold gender equality. And with that, it's back to you, Tanvi.
Thank you, Abhishek. And now before we end the bulletin, the headlines once again. Government to move Muslim Women Protection of Rights on Marriage Bill in Rajya Sabha today. Prime Minister Narendra Modi says any decision on Ram Temple only after court's verdict. Says his government's priority is to empower the farmer by pulling him out of debt trap. Army Chief Gen Bipin Rawat reviews security situation along LOC and hinterland in Jammu and Kashmir. Reserve Bank offers relief to small and medium manufacturing entrepreneurs. allows restructuring of debt up to 25 crore rupees. No need for license under Arms Act to manufacture defence, aerospace and warship items, says government. And in Women's National Boxing Championships, Chandigarh, Delhi and Punjab boxers swept away majority of wins on second day. And with that, we end the morning news. Have a nice day.